That'll come as no surprise to learn we get a lot of complaints about ads on the telly. They're too loud, they're too offensive, or they're just plain annoying. Mm-hmm. I love them, they pay my wages.
Yes, exactly. But, good or bad, at least you're aware they're happening.
Hold on. What about, though, ads that are too short? You know, the kind of blink and you miss it short. Could they actually be a case of the dreaded subliminal messaging? Garth investigates.
Peter McDermott is of sound mind and body, but lately he says he's been seeing things.
They're definitely adverts.
At first, these messages were too quick for Peter to see.
How did you notice it? Well, to be honest, my son noticed it, and perhaps his eyes are younger than mine.
Then Peter started looking for them.
I've seen adverts for the Lego movie, for Captain Marvel, for Continental Soup and chewing gum.
He's now realised they've been there all along, and Peter doesn't like it. Are these subliminal messages aimed at getting into our heads without us even realising? He asked for our help, and we couldn't resist taking a look. Consciously, that is.
There's something just not right, and they shouldn't be there.
If Peter watches all evening...
I could probably see, say, 3, 4, 5 of these one-frame adverts.
Most TV ads are at least 15 seconds long, maybe 5 if you're watching online and hit skip. A flash frame is about 40 milliseconds, barely there. Hardly worth worrying about.
There we are. So that was the Continental.
Fancy a cup of soup?
Well, I don't, but actually now that I see the advert, it's put the thought in my mind.
All of this was happening on Sky TV on the History Channel. Plenty of Tudor England and ancient mysteries, but no show explains this phenomenon. Peter wasn't too fussed until he saw an ad for liquor flashed up on screen.
The one that really upset me was the Bundaberg range of alcohol on it, and I think really that is not acceptable.
Unacceptable because of the risk it might pose to someone more vulnerable.
Not a drinker actually, but quite right. You know, there is the potential that perhaps if somebody could be drying out or, you know, on the wagon, and that could just be the sort of thing that tips them over.
But would it actually? We need an expert, someone who can offer a glimpse into the human psyche and the world of advertising.
I think this consumer's actually got a point when they say this doesn't seem the right thing to do.
That's because of that alcohol ad. Booze ads are more regulated than most.
What you're talking about is an advertisement that probably sits around the threshold between supraliminal, or able to be observed, and subliminal, or not able to be observed. And that threshold differs by individual.
The difference between subliminal or not can come down to how long or short the ad is and whether you're aware there is an ad.
So we know that those subliminal messages do have an impact, but we can't say definitively that they're going to be that strong or they're going to last a long time. And what we want as an advertiser is the strength of that impact. We want a call to action, and we want you to keep repeating that action.
Turns out there are lots of examples that sit just at our level of awareness.
Walking down the street and you smell that smell of hot bread and you walk into the nearest Subway, that's a really good example of how that's actually working for you. Or when you go into perhaps a store on the high street and you react negatively to the music that's being played, it's a good cue to you subconsciously that that store just isn't for you. It doesn't have products that really suit who you are.
At home, watching TV, however, the flash frames like the ones Peter saw have a much harder time influencing our behaviour.
If you are an advertiser and you use this type of advertising, you're expecting them to get up off their couch in that moment, to go outside, get in the car, go down the road and buy whatever it is you're selling. And the reality is the couch is comfortable, it's winter, it's warm inside, they probably won't do that.
So do we need to be on the lookout for more of these blink and you miss it ads? Sky says the ones on its channel are less subliminal, more unintentional.
When Sky receives content from an international source, the adverts from that country are also included. In this case, we received the feed for the History Channel from Foxtel in Australia.
A team here marks the international ads for replacement, but in this case the markers had drifted a bit, allowing flash frames to creep in.
Our broadcast team have been notified and are looking into this to ensure it does not occur in any future broadcasts.
Because it's unintentional, the Advertising Standards Authority will have no problem with Sky on this occasion. TV programs like Fair Go are covered by different rules, but these no longer cover subliminal techniques. But have you been watching carefully? If you noticed these, you weren't seeing things. Whether they work is a completely different matter.
Very tricky, Garth.
Very tricky. Mm. Now, good thing to know that subliminal ads, A, they're not a thing, but if they were a thing, they're actually not that effective in terms of staying in your mind and getting you to buy stuff. They're gone.
Exactly.